October 12 marks the official opening of the cruise season for Saint Lucia with the arrival of the cruise vessel Celebrity Equinox. Ahead of this opening, however, the Ministry of Tourism thought it necessary to bring together various tourism stakeholders to discuss areas pertinent to the cruise sector. Tourism Officer for the Maritime Sector in the Ministry of Tourism, Samantha Charles, reveals that the discussions are necessary due to the island experiencing more relaxed public health protocols.
So what we are doing here today is, among other things, having some input from our stakeholders on the revised protocols for the cruise sector. Dr. Fosua would have alluded to the changes and what brought about those changes in terms of having a more relaxed atmosphere for our cruise passengers. We're also looking at areas pertaining to logistics at the port, anything that needs amending, tightening to ensure that the guest experience is heightened. We're also looking at areas pertaining to traffic management, how we have proper coordination with our land transportation service providers in meeting the needs of our visitors, but also in ensuring that we have very little or no congestion at our main areas of pickup, i.e. Laplace Carinage. So, and also safety and security, which is another critical component. So we have, as part of the dialogue today, the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, accompanied by the Traffic Department, to ensure that we identify any additional safety measures that can allow for a very positive environment for our visitors to enjoy the St. Lucia product.
National epidemiologist Dr. Michelle Francois says there has been constant dialogue with tourism officials for a smooth transition to, quote, normal operations for the tourism and cruise sector. Dr. Francois remains confident that the island is adequately prepared for the influx of cruise visitor arrivals.
We have worked integrally with the Ministry of Tourism, the Tourism Authority, and all other stakeholders within tourism to ensure that we had a smooth transition, and we kept at the same time balancing the health of St. Lucia. So as we strive to return to normal in St. Lucia, and so too with the cruise season, we continue to work with them. We recognize the importance of tourism to our country. And so the Ministry of Health, together with the Ministry of Tourism, this is the first, I imagine, in a long line of meetings, and that we are going to meet to discuss our protocols, to discuss ways as we keep improving our tourism industry and our cruise industry. And we're very eager to see the cruise season commence.
CEO of the St. Lucia Tourism Authority, Lorraine Charles St. Jules, reveals that the SLTA's work continues in promoting the St. Lucian product as the organization prepares for participation in the Florida Caribbean Cruise Association conference next month. The SLTA CEO says policy decisions must be made to create a more accommodating environment for multiple cruise stakeholders.
Internally, we've done some marketing. We've attended FCCA in April. I will be attending the global FCCA next month as well, to ensure that from a policy level that St. Lucia is ready. All the major companies, the presidents, the owners of all the cruise ship major companies that come to the Caribbean will be coming to that conference next month. So the intention is, from a policy level, let us see where St. Lucia stands and how competitive we are, not just for this season, but beyond. Because as you know, it really affects not only the St. Lucia Tourism Authority, the taxi drivers are affected, all the service providers are affected, so we want to ensure that we are ready. So we are going to market to present all the services that we have, all the cruise companies like the Coxswain Company, the Ince, Foster and Ince. They have joined us. They have provided us a lot of feedback from what the customers are asking. And we are, as a destination, with the Ministry of Tourism, we have prepared the product to ensure a great, successful cruise season 2022.
The Ministry of Tourism anticipates a vibrant cruise season with multiple inaugural visits. However, work continues to ensure visitors have the best authentic St. Lucian experience. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.